want to know what it's like. What's it called? It's one night. Oh, I can't remember what it's called. Hi, I'm ENI, and this is 50 for 50 with District Magazine and Hennessy. My favorite rapper, I have two, Meek Mill and Lola Brooke. I think the most overrated rapper is Drake, because he sounds the same in every song, I'm sorry. Oh, I think the most underrated rap is Lakia, actually. Yeah, she's been rapping for a while and like she still hasn't been able to go mainstream, but she's amazing. I wish people would see that. I don't have a favorite rap group. I normally listen to solos, but I have a favorite rap duo, which is DBE, D Block Europe. I like them. Ooh, my favorite rap song is Dreams and Nightmares by Meek Mill. I don't know, it just gets me amped up. Like I'm just like, ooh, like it gives me energy every time. I feel rich when I listen to it. It's actually from Dreams and Nightmares. Hold up, wait a minute. Y'all thought I was finished. What about the ASMR? Y'all thought it was finished? Yeah. Without a doubt, it's either Bodak Yellow. The best club banger would either be Bodak Yellow or Act Up, because it gets everyone turned every time. Oh yeah, I would have a rap song, Too Much by Lakia, but it's really toxic, so probably not the best song to play at a wedding. But it like really evokes a lot of emotions out of me. My earliest hip hop memory would be when Moment for Life dropped with Nicki Minaj and Drake. And that's when I first discovered my love for her and being like, wow. Then I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. Like it's such a classic, timeless song and it's rap, you know, I love that, yeah. My favorite producer would be Metro Boomin because like he always makes a hit, yeah. My favorite music video would be Motorsport, but it's only really for that Nicki Minaj scene where she's like crawling on the ground, like behind the car. A loose leaf when that strap blow. I'm with a couple bad bitches that'll rip the party. If Quavo the QB, I'm Nick Lombardi. Pull up in a space coupe on a link with Marty. I can actually afford to get a pink Bugatti. I want to recreate that so bad, I won't lie, it's so iconic, I love it. And the fact that she came together with Cardi to make a hit and then dissed her in the song, like, it's just iconic. I've never bought a record in my life because we can stream music. The last artist I listened to was Lola Brooke and it was Dummy Yummy. I don't know, I just love her voice. Like, I love Lola's voice. It's just so strong and there's so much, a little bit of masculinity in it, but in a really sexy way, I love that. My theme song would be So Delusional by Lola Brooke. You can see there's a theme here of who I really love. Or Doja Cat. I wanna know what it's like. What's it called? It's one night me. Need to know, yes. Oh, my best slow jam would be Summer Walker, I'm There. If you call me, I'm there. Like, ooh, I pull up, hop out.
It's when you call it, I'm there. Like, ooh, I pull up, hop out. Ooh, you call it, I'm there.
I think my favorite collab album would always be, even though I said Drake is underrated, and really I like it because of 21 Savage, I think that Drake and 21 Savage together are undefeated. Ooh, and Gunna and Lil Baby go well together. Oh, I kind of already answered it. Yeah, when Nicki Minaj dissed Cardi on her, like in the track that she was with Offset and Cardi and Nicki, she dissed her in the song and I was like, wow. Oh my God, my favorite Irish rapper is Keems, and I just discovered him from Simba's Den. It's like a rap battle thing. I was like, why haven't I heard you before? I mean, his flow, his cadence, his bar is very talented. You should check him out.
I'm in love with Tracy, the values key to your heart. Darling, I'm breaking true. Wake up when I'm out too late. One day I'll make it true. It's just me and you.
I think the best Irish hip hop track that's ever been put out would be Dublin by Cello. I mean, you can't really argue that.
Yo, y'all being from Dublin, but you know shit about me. I've never been jail, never been OT. I'm on the seashore in my grafters beat.
It is iconic. A rapper that I would love to have a drink with G Herbo because I think he's hilarious. I'm like, I love funny people. I love humor. So yeah, he'd definitely be on my drink list. But I am my favorite new rapper and I'm really excited to see what I'm gonna do in the future. I think the best decade for hip hop would be 2016 to 2018. That's not a decade, it's 2 years, but like. The best gig I've been to, it wasn't hip hop actually, but I guess I can put MGK in rap, but I would say MGK's concert is very, very good. My guilty pleasure, I'd say, no, she's actually talented, but I wouldn't play her much, would be Flo Milli. Yeah, I wouldn't play her much, but like her voice is hard to like get into it because it's very like animated. But like sometimes I enjoy listening to it. I'm like, okay, you're cool. My favorite album cover would be Cardi B's Gangsta Bitch Volume 1, where she like has a man like in her. Yeah, you can put two and two together. I would like to collaborate with Larry Alibi. I think we have both similar sounds and he's a good rapper. Underrated actually. So yeah, I definitely collab with him. My most listened to album would be In Due Time by Lakia. Yeah, it's very good. Every song is a hit. Every single one of them. No skips. My most listened to artist would be Meek Mill. Yeah, definitely. Oh yeah. An artist I didn't like at the start would be Lotto. He used to previously go as Mulatto. I could never get into her music, and one day I listened to one of her albums, I can't remember the name of it, but I listened to it and I was like, wait, no, there's something there, you know, so I had to take a second look, but she's pretty good, yeah.